Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate some simple techniques to create the two lens flares that you can see here. There's actually more than two because there's a couple of combinations of lens flares in these two videos. But we'll start with the one on the left. So to begin with, we need an object in the scene. I did this all in Eevee, but most of these techniques will work equally well, if not better, in Cycles. So we'll just set the background to black and I'll add an object to form our lamp. Obviously, we can't see a lamp directly. We can only see the light that comes from it. So we need an object that is emissive. So I'll make this sphere quite small and then we'll add a material. Call up a new window and make that a shader editor. And we'll just make sure nicely centered in the view. And here's our default material. So for this demonstration, we need it to be emitting light. So if I just go to rendered view at the moment, turn off overlay, you can see it's completely black. So we'll set the emission to full white so we can see our object now. And I used a strength of about 450. No change at the moment. Now it's Eevee, so we'll immediately go in and put a little bit of bloom into the effect. So we'll switch on bloom here and you can see there it is. That's already starting to create our lens flare effect. I turned the radius down a little bit and I turned the intensity down a little bit as well. Obviously you could select other colors for your bloom if you wanted to. For this demonstration, we'll leave that at white. That's all we need to do in this part. So we'll just press F12 and give that a quick render. So we've got a rendered scene and we'll change this window now to the compositor and say use nodes. So I'm first of all going to add a filter, which is a glare filter, and we'll just drop that there. And you can see what that's doing for us here. Because I wanted to create the sort of stretched classic look, I decided to increase the number of iterations. I used about 5. The size of this, by the way, will be affected by the size of your light source. In order to make it calculate much more quickly, I set this to low. So this is basically how fine the detail of the image is that is used for creating this effect. If you say high, it will use the original detail of the image. So we'll create this flare on even very small dots in the image, but will take much longer to do. So if you go to low, it will actually do it very, very quickly. I increased the color modulation and you can see it's as though we've got various filters on our lenses. And if I increase it a long way, you can really see these colors come out to the extreme. And that might be an interesting effect that you want. I took it up to about 0.5. So there's a little bit of subtle color modulation, but not too much. Threshold is where anything equal to or above the threshold will contribute to this effect. If I increase that, we've got a very, very bright object, so I'd need to put it up to something like 1000 in order to stop the effect. It's quite binary in the way it works, I found. So as soon as you get down below, I guess, the same value of emission of that object, it starts to appear. So it's not a very smooth transition, but you can see there is a transition there. So you can use the brightness of the emission object to cause this to come up like this. So it could be a flash in the scene and that will do that. So as long as it's contributing to the effect. Obviously, if you're a long way below, you'll get a very blocky sort of effect. I think somewhere around there, which is similar to the value of the emission strength, is fine for our purposes. I set it to just 2 for the streaks. Now you can obviously have this much higher. So if I put it on 10, you can see you get this sort of star effect. But I just put 2 and now we get this wide effect. And then the rate of fade, I slowed that rate of fade down quite a bit by increasing that number. So you can see it's stretched out now. And now I felt that it was worth further enhancing this. So I took another one, a copy of that, again, the same image going into it, and added a color mix node. Drop that there. Set it to add and take the output of that one into the color mix node and leave it at 1. So at the moment, they're both doing the same thing and just adding on top of each other. So all they're doing really at the moment is making a brighter set of streaks and making the central point brighter as well. Now if I turn this one down a little bit, you can see what tends to happen. And I'll turn the fade on this top one down a little bit as well. So what that's tending to do is to give us a more washed out bright central point. You can see that bright spot in the middle is less obvious now. So it's brightening the center and obviously not doing too much to the outside because I've changed the fade. And that's all there is to that first one. It's very simple and you can play around with these values obviously to get different effects. You can also animate anything in here just as you can animate the strength of the emission in the object. So we go back to the shader editor. Everything in here is animatable, so you can animate the emission strength to obviously affect this. So we'll now go back to the compositor and we'll just remove these nodes and put that back in there. So we've got our original scene back, and I'll quickly show you how to do the more classic lens flare effect. Obviously it works better with an object that's moving, as I showed in the initial videos that I created, but it will work just as well on a still scene. So again, we're just going to add a filter, which is a glare filter, and drop that in there. I'm actually going to add two glare filters. So let's just render that scene again, and then we can see what's going on. Again, I'm going to have a color modulation of about 0.5, but I'm going to change the mix this time. So if I set mix down to -1, you can see we've just got our original scene. If I set it all up to +1, all we have is the streaks. So 0 is basically a 50-50 mix of the original scene and the streaks. But if I want the streaks to be faded slightly, I can set this to a lower number. So I'm going to set it to -0.4, which is what I used in the demonstration. And you can see it's just faded slightly. Again, I had a threshold of about 500 or thereabouts. It needs to be slightly lower than that, so we'll go for 430 maybe. So we've just about to see our streaks there. And I had 10 streaks this time, and the fade roughly where it is. I'm going to go slightly lower on the mix again, just to fade them out. And it takes slightly longer to composite because I've got medium, the default, for the quality. So there's our central point. And this angle offset, as you might expect, just tilt the whole thing. So once it's composited, you can see it all rotated there. So you could be changing that. You could cause that to rotate as this thing moves around. I'm now going to add another glare node and drop that in there, but I'm going to change this one to ghosts. So I'm just going to select that one and press M to mute it, because that's taking a while to composite. So I just want to take that out while I'm working on this one, and we'll set this one to low. It doesn't make a massive difference with larger objects like this anyway. So you can see we've got these two strange looking effects here that are sort of simulating the refraction within a stack of lenses that is on the end of the camera. So color modulation of about 0.5 was what I used. They're generally much too bright, so I set the mix down to -0.9. It's very easy to overdo these effects. And then you can play around with the threshold, obviously. Now, exactly what effect you get is very dependent on the position of the object in the scene. So if we come out, I've got my sphere selected, and I'll just move it down to here and then render that. You can see we get a very different effect. And as it approaches the center, which is basically the center of where all the lenses are stacked up, and we render again, it actually becomes slightly brighter. And the angle will depend on where this is in the scene. So if I move this over here and render that, you can see it's followed it there. So this will move around with the light source. So I can now select this one again and press M to unmute it. It'll take a moment to render. And you can see we've got that effect as well. If I'm still unhappy with how bright that is, I can dim it down a little there. And that's all there is to these two lens effects. There's actually several in there, of course. But I hope you found that useful. If you did, let me know. Please don't forget to subscribe. That really helps me out. And like the video if you got something out of it. And I will see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.